has won race number two of the day. So Paul Wecker has to step it up, as does Just a Canter, his last start winners ahead of this racing surface at Avondale, which, as I said, a heavy 10 now. But David Green to talk about his runner and Just a Canter in this race. And David, he built nicely to get that win on your home track last time out.
Yeah, he's always been a horse that we've got a lot of time for. He's just been a bit slow clicking on to a few things. Blinkers sort of worked the trick for him, and now it's his time to kick on with it.
Okay, so you've given the horse a bit of a break in between runs for today?
Yeah, he had a couple of weeks off. He's freshened up nice, and bring him back here and kick him off again over 1,200. We said we were going to start him on a slow but not a heavy, but I see that's just changed now. So there you go, we're starting on a heavy. Yeah. So that's a little question mark, but apart from that, he's going really good.
Okay, well, you're probably drawn to maybe try and get the spot in the right part of the track anyway, if you can wind into the race well enough and are going well on the point of the bend to get into that sort of centre part of the track.
Yeah, if he's as long as he's getting through the ground, I think he's going to be able to get himself in the right spot to give him a chance here.
Cool. And of course, this horse won when you became a new dad as well, too, I understand.
Yes, and he's grown up fast and given his mum lots of sleepless nights. And
oh, not dad.
Oh, I think once you get to number four, there's something about your hearing where you can't manage. You hear your first child cry at night, but after that, I don't know what happens. You can't hear them. But Heidi's doing a brilliant job. She's a great mum. So there you go.
Good stuff. Well, congratulations, David, and all the best here as well.
Thank you.
Good one. That's David Green talking about his charge here in this race in Just a Canter, and it's at a price of $3 fixed odds, $3.20.
Yeah, definitely a major factor in the race, number 9, Moore Wecker, but I'm with the David Green trained runner, number 4, Just a Canter, Michael Coleman to do the riding, and I thought it was a nice win last time out when winning on its home track at Te Rapa. Prior to that, finished second at Ruakaka in behind Rockabye Baby, so it's certainly got the form on the board. I think he can carry on with their winning form from last start, number 4, Just a Canter, ahead of the 9, Moore Wecker, Canter, Be Beautiful and All Fear. The others to come into line. The Westbrook Winery over 1,200 metres. Moore Wecker the favourite at $2.60, $1.60. Just a Canter goes in, so Be Beautiful will be the last one to load up. Daniel Hayne the rider. And the Westbrook Winery, 1,200. Set now as Be Beautiful completes the line. Ready to go. Tina goes up with one towards the outside. Gates open now, they're off. Just a Canter got back at the hop, and back with it was Be Beautiful. Now first away, Lord Ascot to show out from the favourite Moore Wecker. And they show the way by a length here from Arctic Storm third, then All Fear, followed by Just a Canter, it's outside. And two lengths away, Be Beautiful is last. So down towards the 850 metres they go. Lord Ascot, the leader, leads a half length from Arctic Storm. Moore Wecker trails third. Just a Canter works around on the outside of it to be fourth, and 1.5 away, All Fear. And last of the six is Be Beautiful. There's four lengths first to last. 600 metres to go. Arctic Storm now worked around a takeover here. Just a Canter tracks it into the race. Moore Wecker between runners, and on the inside, Lord Ascot. Two lengths away, Be Beautiful and All Fear as they swing into the straight now. 400 metres to go. Arctic Storm the leader. Just a Canter ranged up on the outside. Moore Wecker still there on the inside with Lord Ascot. Two lengths away then to All Fear, looking to run on. Down to the 200 they come. The leaders now have got Just a Canter. Moore Wecker the inside. Orfeas still a running on late. It's Moore Wecker in front from Just a Canter. Orfeas switches to the inside, but Moore Wecker and Just a Canter are going to fight out the finish. Just a Canter got up. Just a Canter on the outside beat Moore Wecker. Third was Orfeas. Then fourth at the line was Arctic Storm. Then Lord Ascot. And Be Beautiful will be the last of them home. Number 4, Just a Canter. It's fought back doggedly on the outside for Michael Coleman and trainer David Green, and we'll take it. Moore Wecker had the lead at about the 150, but Just a Canter really knuckled down to it, the son of Puran Canto, and he's going to go back-to-back. That's win number 2 from just 5 race day appearances. And Just a Canter goes on to score here from a game. Moore Wecker, who tried hard on the inside. All Fear will be third, and Arctic Storm fourth ahead of Lord Ascot and Be Beautiful.
You good battle between these two horses that were right in the market. Just a canter closed off as the favourite and gets over the top of More Wicker, who was the second favourite. Here's confirmation.
The winner is 4, Just a Canter. Second, 9, More Wicker. Third, 12, Orfea. Fourth, 5, Arctic Storm. Fifth, 11, Lord Ascot. And sixth, 10, Be Beautiful. Horses to A, 4, 9, 12, 5, 11, 10. The winner's time was 1:13.77.
So the four wins Just a Canter. He's a son of Perrin Canto. He won last time to the races on the 20th. She's been really gallant to the line to finish into that second spot. Orfea into third and Arctic Storm into fourth. So it's going to be a favourable first four with those third and fourth runners in behind also in the market. All right, David Green's about to join us. What did you, David? Look, he was able to cop conditions best. The two favourites got away from them, and he was able to win on the line.
Yeah, very workmanlike performance there. Looked like Mickey obviously knew what he was doing there and got up where it counted.
A couple of midweek wins under the belt now. Is he a horse that you feel as though can get to Saturday grade?
Yeah, absolutely. I think there's a nice three-year-old race at Tauranga in 2.5 weeks, and on the 25th, I think it is, and we'll be going to that next.
And as we press on into the autumn part of the season, I suppose it's comforting to know that you've been able to cop a track like this in a 65 grade.
Yeah, well, it does rain a bit in New Zealand, so it helps for sure.
All right, what do you need, David?
Thank you.
That's David Green, winning trainer in race number 7, the 4 in Just a Canter. 4, 9, 12 and 5 will be those numbers across the line. Steve, we've got one to go. Race number 8, a 65 over the mile, set down to start at 5:42.
Yes, horses clearly are getting better with time, and Just a Canter by Perrin Canto, raced by Jeremy O'Rourke from Lodge Real Estate, and they'll be delighted with that. We actually backed it their big day at Te Rapa, didn't win on that occasion. It's come out since and won twice. Isn't that the way to go? Isn't that always happen? 4, 9, 12 and 5. 4, 9, 12 and 5. Got up in the last bound or two. $3.150, 160, no third. The Quinella 4 and 9, $4.30. Trifecta 4, 9, 12, $28.90. And your first 4, 4, 9, 12, 5, $52.60. $52.60. What about pick six? What's it done? 25,000 guaranteed. We're down to just 15. Basically just 15 live units. Numbers you require thus far. 5, 3, 5, 6 and 4. 5, 3, 5, 6 and 4. There, pick 6. Okay, we're going to have a quick look at the